An acronym is a word that expands into its own definition. Each letter of the word grows into an entire word, starting with that letter. The website acronomy.net proposes to define every word in this way. It's an online acronym dictionary that anyone can edit, and it has grown to more than 3,000 entries. But there's a lot more work still to do. At the current pace, it will take 50 more years for us to reach 100% completion. My question is, how do we get there faster? If you get stuck on one of these, it might occur to you to try using autocomplete. This is fun and gives us results quickly, but it's not actually very good. What we really want is good predicted text. Fortunately, recent technological advances have made that quite possible. We can use some open source neural networks called GPT-NeoX, and the Pythia family of pre-trained models gives me something that snugly fits onto my graphics card. To use the model, I give it a textual prompt, and it predicts what it thinks should come next. I can keep starting over, and it will keep giving me different completions. That's because every prediction it makes is in fact a full probability distribution. At each step, what's being predicted is something called a token, which is somewhere between a single letter and a full word. Since we have the probabilities for each step, we can multiply them together to get the probability of a full sequence. We take logarithms of all that, and now we have a nice numeric score. The closer the total score is to zero, the better the definition is, according to the model. Each space separating two words always gets absorbed into the initial token of the second word. We factor out a word break pseudo-token, and then we enforce acronym validity by ignoring initial tokens that don't start with the correct letter. At the end of a definition, we always add a period. Its contribution to the score penalizes definitions that stop too abruptly. Now we can let this churn for a while, and we will keep the best result. We can also try reusing words from our current best definition. This way, we can gradually converge to a local optimum. When we find something we like, we can submit it to acronomy.net. I packaged up these ideas into an interactive tool called Acronomy Assistant. Here's me on Twitch TV demonstrating how it works. Acronomy Assistant is open source and available for you to download on GitHub. So what else could you do with this? Well, you might make some mnemonics so that you can remember the difference between commonly confused words. You might compose some slogans for your prestigious computer science conference, or you might take an entire novel and expand it as an acronym into another novel. And there's no reason to stop there. I'm sure that you can think of lots of other fun things to do too, so please go forth and acronymize.